Hey Julie, this is my neighbor Wanda, and she's here to support Julie Day or Julie Month this month. So say hello, Wanda. Wanda?
Hello.
There you go. You want to tell us anything about yourself?
Well,
she's supporting you today, Julie, and I can't see myself, so anyways, that's Wanda. Hey Julie, this is Wanda again. We just finished Saturday Night Fever, and we were talking about your video, and what did you say, Wanda?
Said it seems like she already know her.
You seem like you already know her.
Yes.
And I thought, well, damn it, I have to get that on film. So I told her to wait a minute while I got the camera.
Yeah, that's nice.
So.
Well, I hope you get well.
Yep. All right.
Yes.
I'll talk to you later, baby.
Okay, bye-bye.
I'm 46 today and just received my very first kiss at 46 from my dearest neighbor, Wanda.
Yep.
Say hi, Wanda.
Hi there, how are you? Happy birthday.
Thank you.
You're
welcome. All right, that'll do. This button. Okay. There's Wanda.
Yeah.
There's me. And I'm testing this theory out on interviewing people about life and anything else they want to chat about. So there's Wanda.
Yes, my dad, he's a nice guy, and so was my mom, and we played music together, we sung together, and we went and drive-in theaters, we went camping, and everything. My brother played guitar, and like so does Mike, the one that's got Alzheimer's disease now.
Is Mike your brother?
Yeah, he is.
Okay.
And his daughter's with him right now from Kansas City. I mean, Texas. And so that's nice. So he's got some company, and I can't go and see him because I can't drive or anything, you know. But, and I love my mom, still miss her yet today, but it's the way things goes, I guess.
So your mom's passed away, I guess?
Yeah, she has, so did my dad.
Yeah.
And my older brothers, Jimmy and Leland, and Leslie, my youngest brother, and Melvin, Donnie's last one that passed away.
So are you the last one of your family?
No, I got two sisters and a brother. And I'm the oldest.
You're the oldest, huh?
Mm-hmm. I almost went, but didn't. And then they're not well at Londonism now. Say it. Kentucky.
Yeah.
And Barbara lives in Childs.
In where?
Childs. It's above Marysville.
Oh, okay.
Browns Valley. And she thought she had a heart attack with the doctors yesterday. But they told her to go home and make an appointment at the checked. And so she's back home and boy, her kids ever hit me, boy. I told you should call the cops. You can't keep hitting you hit her son.
You know, so who was this?
Barbara, my sister.
Her sister?
Yeah, her son hits her, and I may call the cops. I can't do that, or he'll get out, and then he'll probably kill me. What? And she's stuck and everything, and he gets on this dope and stuff and do that. My kids will never hit me, man. There's no way.
Put your foot in their ass first, huh?
Oh, yeah. Put them somewhere, yeah. But anyway, my mom and dad was nice people. He really was. He was a mechanic. And he never had a car that ever came back after he fixed it.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And mom liked that, spat all of us, and dad got mad. She went down to correct it. Ted him at the table and gave us watermelon, you know. Dad got mad about it.
Yeah.
And he intentionally gave in. He gave us a turkey that Mum did. But his name was Harry the Bum.
Okay.
Yeah, he's a nice guy.
Harry the Bum?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So, anyway, he gave us that turkey. Mom fixed it. And that was nice of him, you know. Then we went camping and chicken hawk up above Forest Hill every weekend.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was nice.
Well, it's good. You have good memories.
I really miss those days. I do. You know, you used to go to drive-ins, and there were no more drive-ins anymore. And
so, if you could travel, have you ever wanted to travel? A lot, you know, like go to Europe or something?
I have this crabbled. God, man, what?
You want a sip of water?
No, it's not that, it's me.
Yeah, I know, but you could cover it up with a sip of water, right? Yeah. Sometimes I'll do that, because my mouth gets dry.
Oh, yeah, when I got married, I got crabbled with my husband's.
Oh. You got crabbles?
No, crabbled. I can't say it.
Crabbled? Is what I heard.
No, crabbled. I did the long trips and like that.
Okay, oh, you traveled.
Traveled. Yeah.
Traveled, okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
All right, say it one more time. Traveled.
Crabbled.
Traveled.
Crabbled.
That was better. The last one was better. Yeah. One more time. Traveled.
Traveled.
Okay, that was pretty close. We'll work on that.
I walked.
So, if you were to travel anywhere in the world, where would you go?
Ireland.
Ireland?
Mm-hmm. The Irish people are.
Well, my friend Steve Jones, he's been to Ireland.
That's my maiden name. He's called Jones.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Maybe you two are related.
No,
I doubt it.
No, I don't know. I don't really know him. I don't even know my grandmom.
Well,
grandpa.
You and I are neighbors, and that's related enough, right?
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. You know, didn't meet half my cousins or any of them.
So you'd like to go to Ireland?
That's where my dad's was from.
Well,
but he's gone too, but
I know that Steve has a lot of pictures of his trip to Ireland.
Mm-hmm.
I could probably access them, but it would take a really long time.
Oh, yeah.
But why don't we plan on that sometime, showing you pictures of Ireland?
Yes.
I know he would be interested in it.
Yeah, it's nice and green and
see when I never did anything really on camera with John, but he had talked about some beach. I don't know if it was in Alaska or Canada, but where they were build sandcastles all the time. Mm-hmm. And he talked about that. And I go, okay, well, let's go online, see if we can find you some pictures.
Yeah.
And nice. I'm sure that there's plenty of travel pictures about Ireland.
Oh, yeah.
So
sometimes I see things on television about Ireland, you know, nice and green, and it's nice.
Well, I'll have to get some pictures, and I'll get Steve to help me out, because he knows the territory. He's been there.
Okay. Oh boy, he's at the Joe Jones, right?
Yeah, Steve Jones.
Yeah.
I'll have to tell him that was your maiden name.
It was. Yeah.
Well, cool. Okay. So we'll start working on that. See, it's always good news with you. I mean, you have told me some bad or sad stories.
Yes.
But you're always interested in talking about the positive.
Oh, yeah. I like to think positive.
Yeah.
Instead of negative.
Yeah. But you aren't afraid to say shit.
No, I'm not.
Or belch.
No.
You know, yeah, yeah. And you're definitely one of my heroes.
Thank you.
You remember me talking about how, or asking you if you would need me to carry you on your shoulder, right?
Oh, yeah.
And you remember what you said in response?
Yeah. They talk to you on my shoulder. Yeah,
yeah, you're going to carry me on your shoulder.
Yeah, I was going to do it.
And you were my hero after that. You know, But I do remember the first time I saw you, that I recognized who you were. You were in this wonderful swirly tie-dye shirt. Do you remember wearing that? It's like a rainbow, but it's twisted in a spiral. They call it tie-dye. Yeah, I don't know, but I had a shirt just like that in high school. You know, not I mean, it's like multicolored like that, but that's definitely not tie-dye.
No.
But yeah, I thought, well, that's cool. She's walking around in tie-dye. I need to know this person. So I'm glad to have.
I remember it, but.
Well, I'm just glad to have overcome my shyness and gotten to know you a little.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was always kind of bashful when I was young, too. I used to even hide behind my mom, and I used to go and hide behind the couch. And I don't know if it was because I was bored or what it was, you know.
If you were afraid, you mean?
Maybe afraid or something. Right, I was going to get burned again. I was burned when I was 5 years old.
Yeah.
And my brother Melvin was got accused of it, but I never did think it was him. You know, I never did. He was told 4 and I was 5.
So you had good reason to be shy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, to be cautious.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm cautious now, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I looked in the mirror and everything.
Did what now?
I looked in the mirror and I used to kiss the kid in the mirror, you know.
You see what in the mirror?
Dude, I kissed the mirror. You know, not me in the mirror.
You kissed a mirror?
Yeah.
Oh, to like practice?
I was just a little girl then.
Okay, okay.
Dancing and little show, you know, off and all stuff.
All right, I wasn't sure how recent this was.
Oh, yeah, I was about 9, 10.
Oh, okay.
I was young.
Not 75.
Oh, no.
Wasn't last year.
No, it wasn't.
Okay.
No.
That makes more sense then.
Yeah, it does. And I still like the mirrors. I don't kiss them or anything now, but I did when I was little.
Yeah. So, did you ever go on any hot dates? That you like to recall?
Well, I worked the Darwin's dad. And I was even a virgin then. And then he tried to touch me that like that. Now, he may not do that. No.
To what? Not talk about sex?
Or touch me or, you know.
Right.
Yeah. But we went to the chicken hawk. He went and Dad went, Mama always went, and he caught me to get in the back of his trunk before we had sex.
Yeah.
So I got pregnant too.
Oh, you did the first time, huh?
Yeah.
Now,
I was only 15.
Now, he didn't force himself on you, did he?
No.
No, but you were just playing around being a dirty teenager.
I don't know if he'd said it, but dirty, but...
See, very good. See, everyone else would have called you dirty, but you didn't see it that way.
No.
Good for you.
No.
Good.
Then he married me, and he was already married to someone else.
He was married to someone else, and then he married you?
Yes.
So did he have two wives, or did he get a divorce?
He told me that Evelyn, his wife, was his cousin. I even got married in her rings. And after I married them, then he wanted the out rings back. And he was married to her. He married me. He was a bunch of... They never did support their own Darwin. And what the welfare what they don't die when.
So everybody's on welfare.
Until I was 18, 21, when I was in that wreck, got some money. But I had to wait till I was 21.
But you were 15 when you were pregnant?
Oh, yeah.
And how old was he?
21.
Yeah. So he really should have gone to jail for that.
Yeah, but my dad didn't do it.
You didn't do it?
No.
You didn't have him arrested?
No. Sure, but didn't.
So, I take it you had the baby?
Oh, yeah, after I was pregnant when my mom died.
Oh.
I had the kids 2 months after she died. I had him at 7 months instead of the whole time.
So he was premature?
They were premature, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, from the way my mother described me, I'm pretty sure I was immature.
Mm-hmm.
Or premature. Immature.
Yeah.
I am also immature, but I was,
see,
I think I was premature.
I got to go home, but they didn't get to go home right now.
My mom described me as the only tan baby amongst the bunch.
Tan was in me there.
That my color. I was kind of tan skin, all the other babies were bright pink.
Oh yeah.
So I've learned that usually is a sign of premature birth.
Mhm. Yeah, they were, but they're smart though. Dylan and Darwin both is smart. They had a high school education. You know, he works.
See, I've got a theory on that. I think our birthing time is we're allowing too much time. We're allowing a layer of stupidity to grow on the human brain if we let them go to full term.
Yeah.
Because I don't know, just it seems weird. I've never felt normal. And I imagine your kids have also felt that way?
Sometimes. But Dale and Darwin have both has good jobs and work when they're 10 years old. As a boy, mowing lawns and always had a job. He's got a job now in Aerojet.
At Aerojet.
Oh yeah. And Dale's got a job in Reno making syringe needles for the mat and the lab.
Oh, yeah?
I've got ever since they were 18 years old. Still got the same job. Oh, yeah, and Darwin Dale was
Take another sip.
I wonder why I do that. Why can't you say...
Just take a sip. You go, oh, no, I'm going to cover this up. I'm going to act like I'm thirsty.
Plus
Mega movie?
No,
neurosurgeon?
No.
Maneuver?
Newspaper,
okay.
Yeah, they delivered...
Newspapers.
Newspapers.
Okay.
Yeah, they did that too.
When they were young, I take it.
Oh, yeah. When they got older, they worked at the gas station. Yeah, they've always had jobs. And Darwin's my dad's favorite grandkids. They get out and they do something. They get jobs and things. You know.
They're good people.
Oh yeah.
Even though they were premature. But do they stand out from the rest of your children?
They are twins.
Oh, they're twins.
Oh yeah, Dylan Darwin's twin. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. So not only are they twins, but they were premature.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. They've always been all right.
They've always been all right?
Yeah.
Now, are they brothers or sisters or brother and sister?
They're both brothers.
Okay, two boys.
Mm-hmm.
And pretty much identical twins or not identical?
They're identical.
Identical.
Yeah, they're good kids. And Garrett, his son's pretty smart too. He goes to college. He's the one who wants my car.
Yeah. So you're saying your grandkid wants your car? Is that what it is?
Garrett, Darwin's son.
Yeah.
He had one, caught one. Garrett. Maybe he'll get it, but I can just give it to him. Try to sell it, you know.
Well, yeah. You maintained it. It's your freaking car.
I know it. I paid $7,500 that car. I got to at least have $3,000. It's in good condition, you know. But Darwin will probably buy it for him, I don't know. But I want crutch money, I don't want no payments. Because, you know, he might be you a little bit of money, then the next month they won't pay me nothing.
Yeah.
You know.
And that's family.
Yeah.
why do people do that, and why do people do that to their own family?
But my brother, I gave him $800 on my credit card, and I never did get a penny back of that money. It was on 87, and I didn't get it paid off until 97. And then he about passed away. I thought that was awful, man. And that was Leslie.
So, if you were to tell everyone in the universe something about life or advice, that's what I'm looking for. What sage advice do you have for anyone and everyone?
they knew what I was going through, boy, they would straighten up.
They wouldn't have what?
They would straighten up.
They'd straighten up?
Oh, God, man, my dad. When I got married and stuff, that was the worst thing I've ever done, was getting married.
Yeah, I'm sorry to hear that.
All of them beat that me up and try to kill me. And all of them gone now.
And what?
They're all gone now.
They're all gone?
Yeah.
I take it you were married more than once?
Well, I was trying to get my kids back. That happened too.
Yeah. But how many times were you married?
I was 6 times.
6 times?
I know none of them was any good.
None of them was any good?
And that last one, man, I tell you,
did it just get worse and worse, or what happened?
Yeah, it just got worse. What the hell did I get into this?
Yeah, so why do people do that? Because I've noticed ever since, you know, my female friends were dating other guys, and they put up with such stupid bullshit. Some of them even put up with physical abuse.
Yeah,
it's
I did.
Why?
I don't know. I had my own home and everything. I shouldn't have never...
Do you feel obligated to them?
No. I could have left them. I should have left them. And when we got married, me and Bud, and we went home, that they had a honeymoon, and he come home and he set a recliner and I lay on the couch and I looked back at him, you know, like that. He said, you know, I can kill you without touching you. What?
Not very romantic, is it?
No. Well, I should have just left the God, out of that door. I should have left.
Yeah. That's disturbing.
Yeah.
That was your honeymoon?
Yeah, going home and telling me that he's going to kill me without touching me. Boy, you wouldn't have liked him.
So how long did you stay with him?
6 years.
6 years.
And I worked out.
6 years after a death threat.
Yeah.
Did you two have children together?
No. We had children with Daryl Darden's dad. No, I was fixed after I had Daryl Darden because I was burnt and they didn't think I could have any kids. I was so tired.
And how old were you when that happened?
I was 16 when I had Daryl Darden.
And right then and there they had your tubes tied?
Yeah, right. I had Daryl Darden. I still say I could have had more kids. But...
Did you really want more kids?
Not really. Not that time. But older than life, I would have liked to have a little girl. But never did.
Yeah, I considered adoption, but even that's just too much for me. I had tried to do that big brother program, and I screwed that up too. I got lost and I was late and, you know, I just never had any confidence in myself, so I'm not a good parent figure, you know. All I can do is instill low self-esteem, and that's not a good thing.
When I got to Darwin back, the worst things I did was in bars.
Wait a minute, what now?
When I got Dylan Darwin back,
yeah.
Lived in Elk Grove, I was doing fine, then I left clearance, packed up my kids, and got that pickup.
So Clarence was the father of the twins?
No, he's just a guy that I was living with.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. He was a nice guy, though. But I left him, but
He was one of the nice ones?
Oh, yeah.
But you didn't stay with him?
No. I went back to Rock, and I should never did that.
You went back to a bad person?
No, I didn't go with anybody.
Well, you didn't go with anyone. But you shouldn't have done...
I would live with my sister, Barbara. With her kids and my kids. But I had to keep... I had to get out because she kept blaming my things, my kids on things. And they weren't doing anything. So I just eventually just got my own place. They're knocking on Grove Street.
Yeah. So it was you and the twins most of the time?
Yes. Yeah, and then... Then I married Wayne. He passed away. Should I beat us? He would amputate his legs. And then I got a divorce, and then I married Bud, which was a mistake. I was already out, got my kids back. Why even married? You know?
So, Bud wasn't their father, though, right?
No.
Bud was number what? Number five?
Bud was the last one, the sixth
one. The sixth, okay.
Yeah.
And he was the one that abused you.
Oh, yeah. He tried to kill me. Knock my feet, knock me down the throat.
And how old were you when this happened?
Probably about my 40s.
In your 40s. So,
yeah.
Over 30 years ago.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's a mean guy, man. He's drinking, oh my God. And smoking in bed. And I got up to go in the truck room on the couch. He came in there, he threw me. Oh, what? You're getting in somebody in the front store. I said, no one's here. I never did go out on Bud. But I think he's going out on me, though.
You mean cheating?
Yeah, cheating on me.
Okay, that makes more sense now.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I never did go out on him. Or none of them. Kind of a person.
But you seem to be around people that are.
Yeah, good, because dad probably do the things to mom. Used to beat her up and stuff too. Dad did. And maybe I just stayed in the same pattern, you know. Right now, I ain't got no boyfriend or anything, but you know, I did.
I made up this term, instead of a white person, I consider myself pewter.
What's that?
P-E-W-T-E-R. It's kind of like a silvery gray. And, but the letters pewter stand for partially educated white trash escaping religion.
I didn't have much religion either.
You didn't have religion either?
I have religious, but I did never had no. I'm not smart. I can't read. I can read, but not that good. I can't spell at all.
But you understand basic concepts of decency.
I understand. Yeah, I do understand.
See, and I have...
We went to the little church when we were little. My mom always had us in the church, you know.
I ended up escaping most of that. My mother drugged me to church every now and then, and I never got it. They made you do weird things, and it didn't make any sense to me. And whenever I listened to any of the words, I was horrified, you know. Yeah, I understand weird dynamics between people, and it just doesn't make sense to me. Well, you know,
some things I can't understand either. Don't put the mean or nothing.
But did
like that? You're saying something about things, and I'm asking you, what's that? You know.
Please, I love it when you do that. That means you're curious, yeah. And to me, that means intelligent.
Oh, yeah.
And intelligence is not based on education.
No, it's not. You know, you could be smart in other ways, and I'm smart in not always, but
yeah.
I don't have to be really bright, you know?
But they're just things that make frickin' sense, and you don't need to know,
no?
You know, where a noun goes in a sentence in order to be nice to someone.
No.
And you don't need to... You know, kneel on a bench
no.
In order to be nice to someone.
No.
You know, you can be nice to someone because it's a nice thing to do.
Oh, yeah.
And frankly, most people like to return the favor, so it's a win-win.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, well, I've always been good to people. I try to make good people and stuff, you know.
Yeah,
I did my brother, my money, I got her a car, she almost killed the kids, and I got him a car, and, but I made it.
Yeah, we're still here.
By myself, but I made it.
We're still here. That's the important part.
Yeah.
That's what makes us superheroes.
Yes.
I've been trying to tell Julie online that we got to be superheroes.
Oh, yeah.
The latest news is...